Beginning on your hands and knees, placing your wrists directly underneath your shoulders and your knees directly underneath your hips. Starting by dropping your chest down towards the floor without bending your elbows. And then push your chest away from the floor by pressing your hands into the floor. This movement is to stabilize the shoulders. And I really want you to feel the pressing sensation as you lift your chest away from the floor. Keep pressing your chest away from the floor, stabilizing the shoulder as you go into rounding your back. So you're gonna round your back, drop your tailbone down and your head down, and then just come back to neutral. Do not go into an extension. Rounding the back and into neutral. Tailbone and head goes down towards the floor, navel pulls up towards the ceiling, and then back to neutral. Continue to stabilize the shoulders by pressing your hands into the floor, brushing the opposite arm and leg out away from your midline, and bring it back in. Inhale as you reach, and exhale as you lower the limbs back down. Inhale as you reach out and away from the center. Exhale as you lower back down. Keeping the shoulders away from the ears, relaxing them down the back, and continue to feel the energy pressing into the floor. Inhale as you reach, exhale as you come back in. Nice. Going into child's pose to relax the lower back. Coming out of child's pose, turn to your side and slide down onto the floor on your side and roll onto your back. Place your feet sit bones width apart, not hips width apart, so that they're inside of your hips. And place your hands on your hips so that you can feel what's happening in your pelvis. We're gonna go into some pelvic tilts. You're gonna push your navel into the floor, your lower back will touch the floor, and now release that and drop your pubic bone down towards your heels, creating space underneath your back. So you're gonna rock between these two points, navel to spine, spine to floor, and then drop the tailbone down or the pubic bone down towards your heels. Again, rocking between these two points just to mobilize the lower back. And now place your hands on the floor. Curl the tailbone underneath you and lift the hips up towards the ceiling, reaching your knees forward over your toes. You want to feel like you're pulling the mat underneath your body as you go into this exercise. This will really kick on the hamstrings. Again, curl the tailbone underneath you, lift the hips up towards the ceiling, making sure the knees doesn't go out to the side, but reach your knees forward over your toes as you melt down bone by bone, oozing the spine down into the mat. And again, articulating through each vertebrae, lifting the hips up, keep the chest relaxed, keep the shoulders relaxed, keep the neck relaxed, keep your jaw relaxed as you ooze the spine down bone by bone. And again, articulating up. And then melting the spine down. The chest melts, the middle of the back melts, the lower back touches the floor, and then the tailbone drops down towards your heels. Again, curl the tailbone underneath you, lift the hips up towards the ceiling, reaching the knees over the toes, and then ooze the spine down. And just allow your breath to be normal here. Don't focus too much on the breath. Just make sure you are breathing. Feel like you're opening the hips and softening the chest down into the mat. And again, articulating through the lower back reaching the knees forward, keep the chest relaxed, and ooze the spine down, melting into the floor. The floor is your friend. Continue to check in with your body, making sure that your knees don't open out to the side, but they stay in alignment with your hips. Good. Now, take a breath in and lift the hips. And exhale as you lower down. Bring the feet close together. Let the insides of your feet touch. Lift the hips up towards the ceiling into pelvic lift again. Float your right leg up to tabletop and lower that down. And float the other leg up to tabletop and lower it down. Making sure you don't hike the hip. Making sure that one hip doesn't fall towards the floor or the other. You don't want your hips to become a seesaw. And let's now focus on the breath here. So you're gonna exhale as you float the right leg up. Inhale as you lower that leg down. Exhale, float the left leg. And inhale, lower that leg down. Again, checking in with your neck and shoulders, making sure those are relaxed. Exhale, float the left. Inhale, lower it down. Exhale, float the right, keep the hips high. Inhale, lower that down. And exhale, float the left. And lower that down. Reach the knees forward and melt the spine down bone by bone. Excellent. Curl the tailbone underneath you, lift the hips up again. Float the right leg up to tabletop, lower the hips. Now press it up and down and lift for 9 and lower. Lift 8 and 7. You're gonna exhale as you press the hips up. Inhale as you lower down. Make sure you're not hiking. 5, 4, exhale on the way up. 3, inhale on the way down. 2 and 1. Good. Lower the hips, lower the foot. Lift the hips up. Float your left leg up to tabletop. Inhale as you lower. Exhale as you lift. Inhale, lower. This is 9. We're counting down. And 8. 7. Make sure you're pressing the inside of the foot down, the outside of the foot down, and the heel. The heel should stay in contact with the floor, and your knee should reach over your toes. Your chest is relaxed. Your jaw is relaxed. Your entire foot is in contact with the floor. Lower the hips down and lower the foot down. Nice. Separate the legs, sit bones width apart, take a breath in. Making sure that your pelvis is in neutral, so you should not have your lower back on the mat. You should not have an arch underneath your back. You should just have a tiny bit of space under the back in neutral position. You're gonna exhale, float the right leg up to tabletop. Inhale, lower that leg down. Exhale, float the left leg up, making sure you're not hiking the hip. Making sure you're not pressing the lower back into the mat, but you're staying in neutral position. Let your breath work with you or for you. Use your exhale to lift the leg up, cinching in the waist. You almost want to feel like you're wearing a corset. So you inhale wide into your ribs, into your belly, into your back, and you exhale and feel everything knit together in the center of your body. Inhale as you lower the leg down, adding on. Exhale as you lift the right leg up. Now take a breath in and exhale as you lift the other leg to meet it. knitting the ribs together, making sure you're not arching the back. You're gonna tap your toes down onto the floor, and then exhale as you lift. Inhale as you tap the toes down, alternating between legs, and exhale as you lift. You wanna make sure that you don't arch your lower back. If you feel pressure in your back, or if you feel like you have to hold your breath in order to do this exercise, just dial it back down to the one leg at a time. If you feel nice and connected, you can continue. So you're gonna inhale as you tap the toes down and exhale as you lift, maintaining the stability in the pelvis. And just a note, you don't have to touch the floor with your toes. Just go as far as you can without compromising the alignment of your spine. Inhale, lower the left leg, and exhale, float it up. Squeeze the legs together. You're gonna lower both legs down and exhale, lift. Again, if you feel too much pressure in your lower back with this, or if you feel like you have to hold your breath in order to do the exercise, dial it down to the one that we just finished or the one leg at a time. The further away you reach your toes from your hips, the more intense the exercise will become. Inhale as you lower the legs. Exhale, cinch the waist and bring the knees into tabletop. Inhale, lower. And exhale, keeping the ribs knitted together. Excellent. And then lower the feet down. And just do a few pelvic tilts here just to loosen up the spine, loosen up any tension that you built up, and to reset yourself. Lower the arms down onto the floor. Separate your feet, sits bones width apart. Exhale, lift one leg. And then you're gonna take that leg out to the side and bring it back to center. Imagine that you're balancing a cup of tea on the knee that's on the floor. So as you move the right leg out to the side, make sure your left leg doesn't go out to the side as well. You want to keep that left knee straight up towards the ceiling as you open the right leg out to the side. You're going to inhale and open the leg out. Exhale as you bring it in. And you also want to make sure that the hips aren't tilting with the leg going out to the side. Stabilizing the pelvis is very important. Let's go to the other side. Float the left leg up. Stabilize the hips. Open the left leg out to the side and bring it back to center. Inhale as you open and exhale back to center. Again, balancing a hot cup of tea on the right knee so the right knee doesn't travel out to the side along with the left. Only the left leg goes out to the side. Relaxing the neck, relaxing the shoulders. Inhale as you open and exhale, bring it in. Excellent. And lower that leg down. Wonderful. You're gonna roll to your side and push yourself up to sitting. With your legs straight out in front of you, your feet are as wide as your mat, so they're wider than your hips. Flex the feet, reach the arms forward. Round the spine forward, and think about pulling your navel into your spine. So your lower back is, you want to imagine that it's pressing up against the wall. So as you round the upper spine and the mid spine forward, your lower back presses back into the wall, imaginary wall that's behind you. So you're going to exhale as you round forward, really scooping out the abdominals, hollowing out the abs. Inhale as you stack the bones on top of each other, building the spine up from the floor to the crown of your head. Hollow out the chest. Exhale and pull the navel into your spine. Inhale as you stack the bones on top of each other. Again, exhale, scoop out the belly, scoop out the chest, and reach it forward so you get a nice stretch in your upper back and your mid back. Place the hands on the floor, walk your hands forward and round forward there. You get a nice stretch in the hamstrings here. Keep the feet flexed as well, so you can get a nice stretch in the calves as well, depending on how tight your calves are. This is a nice gentle stretch for your upper and mid back and lower back as well, without compromising the functionality and your healing core from having a baby. Excellent. Now just place your right hand down on the floor, lift your left arm up towards the ceiling, and side bend over to your right for a nice lateral stretch. And then take it over to the other side, really mobilizing the spine here. And you want to breathe into the side that you're stretching. Coming out of the stretch, and now slide onto your back and then turn onto your stomach, placing both hands underneath your forehead. Drop your tailbone down towards your heels and deepen your navel in towards your spine. Keep your navel engaged as you lift your chest off of the floor along with your arms, and then lower down. Deepen the navel and lift the upper body up. And exhale as you lower down. You don't want to focus on the height. Just gently lifting up, engaging the back muscles, and lowering down. Good. Making sure you're not overarching the lower back. So you want to drop the tailbone down towards your heels and lift the upper body and lower it down. Again, float the upper body up. And lower that down. Nice. Now, tuck the toes underneath. Make sure the legs are a little bit closer together. Straighten the legs so that the knees aren't touching the floor and point your right toes. Now, tuck those toes under. And point the left toes. And tuck those toes under. You're going to continue to alternate between feet. And tuck the toes. Now point the right toes and lower the leg down and lift. And lowering down and lift. You're not bending your knee. You're lowering a straight leg down and lift a straight leg up. Keeping the navel in towards the spine and the tailbone drip down towards the heels so that you're not overarching the lower back. Try to keep the upper body as relaxed as possible. And now tuck those toes under and let's go to the other side. Point the left toes and lower the leg and lift. And lower and lift. Good. You're using your glutes here. You're using your hamstrings here. Just make sure that the leg stays in parallel position. And tuck the toes. To finish, untuck both toes and push yourself back into child's pose. Let the knees spread open. Let the fingertips reach far in front of you. Dropping the head down onto the floor and inhale into your lower back. And exhale, let it go. Go ahead and bring yourself up. And then turn onto your side. Kiss the legs together, stack the hips, create a little space underneath your hips, and I like to call that your mouse house, so that you create length on the top hip. You know, rotate the top leg out for some clamshells, keeping the ankles together. Make sure the ribs are knitted together, so you don't want to flare the ribs open. Close the ribs. And working the side of the glute. Keeping the hips stacked, straighten the leg, point the foot, lower the leg down, and lift, and lower, and lift. And inhale as you lower the leg, exhale as you lift, keeping the ribs knitted together. The abdominals are engaged and the hips are stacked. Good. And rest. Create the little mouse house, stack the hips, knit the ribs together, deepen the navel, straighten the leg, and reach the leg forward as you kick, and then take the leg back. Flex the foot as you reach forward and point the toes as you reach back. Flex the foot and point. And inhale as you reach. Exhale on the way back. Inhale and exhale. Shoulders are relaxed. And as you reach the leg forward, think about the hips reaching back. So you don't want to tuck your tush underneath. You want to keep the neutral spine. Flex forward and point back. And flex and point it back and rest. Take a breath. Straighten the leg. Turn the leg out. Make sure the hips are stacked. Really rotating the thigh bone. And going into some circles. And reach it forward, around, and back. Forward, around, and back. Again, maintaining the mouse house underneath your hips. And reverse. Jaw is relaxed, shoulders are relaxed. And rest. Great. Push yourself up to sitting so that you can turn to the other side. Lower yourself down onto your side. The arm is stretched out. Lower the ear on the arm. Create the mouse house underneath the waist. Knit the ribs together. Engage the abdominals. Stack the hips. And clamshells. Rotating out and lowering down. Keep the feet together. Nice easy breathing here. Just working the side of the bum. And then straighten the leg. You can place your hand down for stabilization. Lower the leg down and lift. And lower and lift. Relaxing the shoulder. Maintaining the stability of the pelvis, keeping the ribs knitted together. Only working the side of the bum. That's where you should feel it, on the side of the bum. And rest. Now create the mouse house, knit the ribs together, engage the belly, reach the leg, flex the foot forward, and point the foot as the leg goes back. And flex and point as you go back, opening the hip. And flex and point. When you reach the leg forward, you should feel a stretch in the hamstring. So as the foot goes forward, the tailbone reaches back, creating this oppositional pull that you feel in the hamstring. And flex forward and point back. Flex forward and point it back. Nice and relax. Re-engaging everything, setting up your details, straighten the leg and now turn the leg out and going into your circles for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, maintaining the hip stability, 2, and 1, now reverse, 10, keep the leg turned out, keep the knee straight, don't let the knee bend, 8, keep the length of the side of the body, And yes, relax. Push yourself up to sitting. Now we're going to go into a stretch. Place your hands behind you, bend one leg, and then cross the opposite ankle over the knee, pushing your chest forward and really lengthening the spine. If you want to deepen the stretch, you can slide the heel back. But for me, I'm just going to keep the heel forward. Really lengthening the spine. And you're welcome to push the right knee out if you need to deepen that stretch as well. Coming out of that, and you're gonna switch sides. Push the chest towards the crossed leg. Nice. Really opening up the hips. We're stretching the muscle that we just worked while lying on our side. And then coming out of that, and now we're going to stretch our hamstrings. So you're going to reach your left leg forward and bend your right knee, placing the foot inside of the left leg, and reach for your toes. But I want you to think of lengthening your spine. You don't want to round your back. Lengthen the spine, not rounding your back, but your spine is straight and you're hinging forward from the hips. The goal is not to reach your toes, but if you can touch your toes, that's great. If not, just place your hand on your shins or your knee or wherever you are in space. Keeping the length of your spine. So you almost want to feel like you're sticking your tush out and switch other side. Again, lengthen the spine, hinge forward to reach forward, making sure that the foot is flexed. Relaxing the shoulders, you're doing great. A few more seconds here. It's great to hold your stretches for at least 15 seconds. If you feel like you can go deeper, definitely go deeper. Coming out of the stretch, and now you're going to come onto your side. Place your elbow underneath your shoulder. Knees are stacked and opening the front of the body by bringing your knees in alignment with your hips. You're going to push your hips up off of the floor, engaging the underside of the body. So if your right elbow is down, you're engaging the right side of your body. And then reach the top arm forward for added resistance. Really pushing the hips up and pushing your shoulder into the floor, making sure your shoulder is not in your ear. Lower the hips down into the floor, push yourself up to sitting, but keep your legs to the side and just lift the right arm up towards the ceiling and side bend over to the opposite side to stretch the side that you just worked. Breathing deeply into that side. Release and then swivel your legs over to the other side and lower your elbow down onto the floor. Again, stack the knees, stack the hips, push the legs back so that you're opening in the front of the hips and lift the hips up off of the floor. Really lift them high. For added resistance, you're going to reach the top arm forward. Making sure there's space between your ears and shoulders. Nice, easy breathing here. Just make sure you're not holding your breath. Cinching in the waist. And lower down. Bring the legs closer to your hips. Lift the left arm up towards the ceiling and side bend over to your right. Deep breathing here. Relax the shoulder down the back. And coming out of that, bring your legs in front of you and you're going to cross the legs. Lift the arms up, open the elbows out to the side and slide them down the back and then slide them up. Open out and slide them down the back and sliding up. So you should feel a stretch in the front of the chest. We get so tight in our pecs here because of holding our babies and breastfeeding and or just feeding our babies. It's very important that we stretch the front of our chest and activate the muscles in the back. Nice. You're done. See you later. Bye. Mwah.